This tutorial will help you install Windows 7 without formatting drive C and data loss. If you have yet not partitioned a hard drive, and there is only C drive in your laptop or desktop PC and all your data is stored there, then this video will help you install Windows without formatting drive C. In addition, this solution comes handy if you have lots of data and other drives are full. By following the given instructions, you can reinstall Windows without spending a whole day to move your data to an external storage device, and again transferring to C drive after installing Windows. As well as, you can install Windows on other drives without data loss and formatting. You have three options for Windows 7 installation: Windows 7 installation DVD stored copy of DVD and Windows 7 ISO image file. You can go for any one of these options. I will be using an ISO image file of Windows 7 for installation. If you don't have an ISO file, then you can use Windows and Office ISO download tool to download Windows 7 ISO image file. You can also use Windows 7 installation DVD if you don't have internet. Using another PC, copy all files from Windows DVD into USB pen drive, local, external hard drive or memory card. To install Windows 7 on a desktop computer or laptop with no DVD drive, Windows 7 does not have the ISO image mount utility. This is why we need a third-party ISO mount software to make use of ISO image of Windows 7. I would like to recommend to use Ultra ISO as an ISO image mount utility. Ultra ISO is a lightweight and can be used for free to mount an ISO image file. You may use any other ISO image mount software as well. Download the free version of Ultra ISO and then install. After installing Ultra ISO, right-click on Windows 7 ISO image file, hover your mouse over Ultra ISO drop-down menu, and click on Mount to Drive F. Drive F is a virtual DVD drive. Drive letter could be different in your system. Go to Computer. Open Virtual DVD Drive. Now run the setup file. Click Yes if user account control box pops up. Click on Install button to kickstart the installation procedure. Please wait while setup copies necessary files. Here you are given two options. Choose the first option. If you are connected to the internet and have enough data to download and install critical updates, you may choose second option, not to download updates. There is no harm. You can download and install updates later. I'm going for first option. Please wait while it downloads and installs updates. Please accept the license terms and click Next. Here you are given two options. Click second option to move to the next step. Do not make any changes here. No format, no other drive. If you choose another drive, then your PC will become the dual boot with two copies of Windows 7. To avoid data loss, all you need to do is highlight drive C and click Next. Setup will make Windows.old folder and move all files and folders of previous installation to this folder. Click OK to begin the installation. Installation has begun. It could take 15 to 30 minutes, depending on system and hard disk speed. To make this video short and avoid boredom, I have cut out 10 minutes of recording. Press Enter key to restart. Don't press any key. It has begun the next phase of installation. The installation is almost complete. Choose your desired language, time and other details and click Next. Write your name and click Next. Choose a password. I'll skip this step and click Next. Enter your product key to activate your copy of Windows. I'm going to skip this step and will activate later. Click on the second option to let Windows only install important updates. Set time and date and then click Next. Click on any one of available options. Please wait. The installation is now complete. After install Windows, Wi-Fi, audio and other devices might not work. Install required drivers. Windows needs drivers to make all devices functional. After installation, move your data you want to keep from Windows.old folder and delete this folder to free disk space. Go to Drive C. Open Windows.old folder. Open user folder. Open the folder with your previous username. Check all these folders to search for your data and move to any other drive or to another folder. After data transfer, you may now delete Windows.old folder and get extra free disk space. Right-click on Drive C. Click on Properties. Click on Disk Cleanup. Click on Cleanup System Files. Tick mark Previous Windows Installations and click OK. Click Delete Files. It has freed up disk space. I now have 12 GB of extra free disk space. In this tutorial, Team Software has tried its best to explain everything very well. But if you run into any problem or have still any question, please do let us know using the comment section. Team Software Geek will try to solve your problems. Please visit softsuggester.com for more info and the download links. Give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to Software Geek and help us make more helpful and informative videos.